Now let's see about static members in Java. We can apply static keyword or modifier on variables, methods and a block. So we can have static variable, static method and static block. In this video we will discuss about what is a static variable, static method and static block. First let's see what is a static variable. The variables which are declared inside a class but outside all the methods are known as static variables. That means static variables are declared inside a class but above all the methods. Let's take this example. Name of the class is test. Here we have a static variable, static int a semicolon. So this variable is declared above all the methods and inside the class. So what is the syntax for declaring a static variable? We have to use a keyword called static. So static space, data type space, variable name. Now let's see when the memory will be allocated for the static variable. Coming to the instance variable. What is instance variable? The variable which is declared inside a class. But here we don't have static keyword. So this variable is called as instance variable. For instance variable, when the memory will be allocated? Whenever an object is created, then memory will be allocated for the instance variable. Whereas coming to the static variable, the memory will be allocated whenever a class is loaded into the memory. So first compilation will be done and after that execution will be done. During execution, that JVM loads that class file into the memory, into the main memory. So during that time, the memory will be allocated for the static variables. Here static variables are class variables. That means static variables are associated with the entire class rather than individual objects. We can create n number of objects for the class. OBJ1, OBJ2, OBJ3. Likewise, we can create n number of objects. Each object has its own copy of instance variables. But coming to the static variable. For static variable, the memory will be allocated only once and all the objects of the class will make uses of that memory. Here we have a statement called static int a. So for a, the memory will be allocated only once and all the objects of the class will make uses this a. Whereas coming to the instance variables, each object has its own memory. OBJ1 has its own a. OBJ2 has its own A, OBJ3 has its own A, like that. So that is about memory allocation for a static variable. So whenever a class is loaded into the memory, then the memory will be allocated for the static variable. For static variable, the memory will be allocated only once and all the objects of the class will make uses of that memory. So when we can use the static variable? If value of the variable is constant for all the objects, then we use the static variable. Whereas for when we can use instance variable, if value of the variable varies from one object to another object, then we have to go for instance variable. Here static variables are nothing but global variables. But in Java we don't have global variables. So in place of global variable, we are using static variable. If you want to maintain common information for all the objects of the class, then we can go for static variable. Now let's see what is the default initial value for a static variable. We know what is default initial value. Here we have a variable called a, but this a is not initialized. So if the variable is not initialized, then some value will be stored in the variable. That value is called as default initial value. For a static variable, the default initial value is 0. Now let's see how we can access the static variable. Static variables are associated with class. So that's why we use the class name in order to access the static variable. So for accessing the static variable, the syntax is class name dot variable. Class name dot variable. Okay. If we want with the help of object also, we can access the static variable. Okay. That is about what is a static variable. Now let's see about static method. If a method is defined with the keyword static, then the corresponding method is called a static method. So static void INCR. So this is a static method. Why? Because this method declaration starts with a keyword called static. So why we use the static method? Mainly we use a static method in order to access the static variables. By using static method, it is not possible to access non-static members. So what is the advantage of static method? Static method allows us to access static variables as well as other static methods. Let me have two more static methods. We can access, we can call those two methods from the static method. So here the point is, with the help of static method, it is not possible to access non-static members. If we try to access non-static members from the static method, then the compiler will generate error message. So static method allows us to access only static variables as well as other static methods. Now let's see how we can access the static method. Here static method is also associated with the entire class rather than individual object. So in order to access the static method also, we have to follow the same syntax for accessing the static variable. So here the syntax is class name dot method. Class name dot method. So this is the syntax for accessing a static method. Now let's see about a static block. Generally, block means a collection of statements which are enclosed in curly braces. So this is called as a block. We can have a set of statements enclosed in curly braces. Whereas static block means it starts with a keyword called static within the curly braces, a set of statements. So this is known as a static block. So static within the curly braces, some statements. Let's see what is the use of a static block. Static block is mainly useful in order to initialize static variables. So we can perform static variable initialization with the help of the static block, as well as we have Java database connectivity, JDBC. So in JDBC we can write database connections in static block. Now let's see when the static block will be executed. Whenever the class is loaded into the memory, then the static block will be executed, just like whenever the memory will be allocated for static variable. So when the memory will be allocated for the static variable, whenever the class is loaded into the memory. So like that, a static block will also be called whenever the class is loaded into the memory. We know that the execution of a Java program starts from main method, but before execution only the corresponding class will be loaded into the memory. So if there is a static block, first that static block will be executed, and after that the execution of the program starts from the main method. Okay, now let's see these two programs. Let's see this program. Here the name of the class is text. Here we have a variable called static int a. So whenever the class is loaded into the memory, then the memory will be allocated for the a. In Java the size of integer is 4 bytes, so 4 bytes of memory will be allocated for a, and the starting address is some thousand. Okay, next, so first what will happen here, we have a static block, static within the curly braces, system.out.println, from static block a is equal to 10. So why we are using static block? Mainly we use a static block in order to initialize the static variable. So here what is the name of the static variable? A. So A is equal to 10. In static block we can access the static variable directly. There is no need to use the class name. Okay. So what is the, we know that first static block will be executed, and after that execution of the program starts from the main method. So first this block will be executed. So what is the statement? From static block. So first this statement will be printed. From static block. Next, what is a value? 10. So in here 10 will be stored. Next, execution of the program starts from the main method. Here we have public static void main string aux. Here we have a statement called system.out.println from main. So the statement will be printed. So from main. From main. Next, system.out.println value of a is. Here we have a variable called a. But here this static variable as well as main method. static variable as well as main method is present in the same class. If the static variable as well as main method present in the same class, then there is no need to use the class name. Why? Because the static variable as well as main method is present in the same class. We can access the variable directly. So value of A is, so what is the value of A? So A contains a value called 10. So 10 will be printed. Okay. Or if you want, we can access with the help of the class name. So what is the name of the class? Test. So test dot variable name A, like that. Next statement, INCR. So what is INCR? INCR is a static method. But how we can access the static method? We can access the static method with the help of class name. But here, the static method as well as main method is present in the same class. So there is no need to use the keyword class name. If you want, we can use the class name also. What is the class name? Test. So test.incr. So whenever the statement is executed, then the control goes to the incr method. So here, what is the statement? System.out.println from static method. So this statement will be printed. So from static method. Next, A is equal to A plus 50. So what is the value of A? 10. So 10 plus 50 means 60. So here 60 will be stored. Next, System.out.println A value is. So what is A value? A value is. So what is A value now? 60. So this 60 will be printed. Okay. So this is one program. And now let us assume that this main method is not present in this class. Let we have one more class, that is class demo. In demo class, we have the main method. So class demo, public static void main string args. And now let's see what will happen. So first this static block will be executed. Next, execution of the program starts from the main method. Next, value of A is, here what is the problem? Static variable is present in test class, whereas main method is present in demo class. So in this situation, in order to access the static variable, we must use the class name. So value of A is plus test.a. So what is test.a? Let us assume that we have some 10. So the 10 will be printed. Okay. Next, test.incr. Here also we must use the class name. Why? Because incr method is available in test class, whereas this main method is present in the demo class. So test.incr. So control goes to the incr method. So the statement from static method, now A becomes 60. So that 60 will be printed. So this is about static variable, static member and the static block.